Hey guys, Level Cap here, and today I'm going to be doing a video review on the AEK Assault Rifle. Now I've talked about the AEK in other video reviews, talked about how amazing it is at close quarters, how it really doesn't have much of a rival in close quarters, unless you want to count the FAMAS, but the FAMAS's reload time kind of takes it out of the picture for me. This thing has that 900 round per minute rate of fire, which makes it just so amazingly destructive. And in the last patch, it got a reload time reduction from 2.65 seconds to 2.55 seconds for the short reload time, and the long reload has been reduced from 3.72 to 3.68. Now, these aren't huge changes, but for the short reload, a tenth of a second is actually pretty important. Now, if you're used to a slightly slower firing assault rifle like I am, I'm pretty used to the M16 and the M416. That fire at 800 rounds per minute and 750 rounds per minute, both respective rates of fire, but if you all of a sudden up that to 900 rounds per minute, the ability to kill quickly for you is just, it's such a big difference between those standard assault rifles. It's just absolutely crazy in close quarters how much more effective you can become with the AEK if you're used to a slower firing assault rifle. Now, I think there's a point that a lot of gamers experience once they've been playing long enough where when somebody pops around the corner, or say you see two people pop around the corner and you start aiming at the first person, you can often anticipate when you need to switch to the next guy and to get both those kills as fast as possible. And oftentimes you jump the gun. You fire at the first person, you waste some of your ammo, and then you switch to the second person. But the first person didn't go down. They still got like 3% health left or something like that. So you really, you just jump the gun. And that happens a lot with some of the slower firing assault rifles, because you're thinking and you're playing faster than the weapon can kill, pretty much. And with the AEK, you really don't run into that issue as much or at all, really, for me. I was able to take quick bursts at the first person and then take a quick burst at the second person, and both would go down. Now, because of the AEK's longer than normal reload time, it's more important with this weapon as opposed to some of the other assault rifles or popular assault rifles that reload faster to conserve your ammo. When you get a first kill, hold off on the reload. Make sure you got at least, you know, 10 to 15 bullets left in your magazine. And hold off, make sure nobody else is coming around the corners, and then reload the gun. Now, you can get away with a little bit more lazy reload mechanics with something like the M16 or the M416 just because they reload so fast. But with the AEK, you really gotta hold off at first, because 2.5 seconds is plenty of time for somebody to sneak up on you and catch you right before you finish that reload. Alright, so let's talk about the recoil and fire spread of the AEK and why it kind of forces it into a close quarter situation, and why I would take something like an M416 over the AEK any day of the week in a long range engagement. Now, early on in Battlefield 3, pretty much all assault rifles had a 0.2 aiming down sight accuracy. This meant that your first few shots would be at a certain level of accuracy, and then beyond there, the recoils of the individual weapons would sort of take over and determine how accurate you could be with sustained fire. But from the get-go, they are all within a certain accuracy range of that 0.2 aiming down sights. Now, they've gone through and they've really retweaked a lot of guns. The F2000 now has a 0.4 aiming down sight accuracy, and the AEK has a 0.3 aiming down sight accuracy. Not a huge change from 0.2, but enough. And to give you an example, carbines on average have a 0.4 aiming down sight accuracy, so they're literally two times as inaccurate, or half as accurate rather, than assault rifles. And you can still kill people at ranges with carbines, but the AEK sort of fits the bill right in between an assault rifle and a carbine in terms of accuracy within your first few shots. Now, in addition to its slightly less accurate aiming down sight accuracy when compared to some of the other assault rifles, the AEK also has a very high side-to-side recoil, which is exactly what you don't want for that long-range accuracy. Now, you might say, well, wait a minute, Level Cap, the M16A3 has a kind of high side-to-side recoil with a 0.1 pull left and a 0.4 pull right. That seems kind of high, while the AEK has a 0.5 pull left and a 0.3 pull right. On paper, it doesn't seem like it's that much higher, but the fact is, having a high side-to-side recoil pull on both sides is actually much more detrimental than having a high side-to-side recoil pull on one side. If you have a high pull on one side of the gun, it becomes much easier to predict and control that recoil. If you have a high pull on both sides of the gun, it becomes very hard to predict that side-to-side recoil because it kind of jerks to the left, then jerks to the right, and it's really hard to anticipate where it's going to shoot. So for the long-range shots, the AK gets a little bit more difficult to control, a little bit more inaccurate. Now, in terms of vertical recoil, the AEK is pretty easy to manage. It does have a little bit of a kick at first, but overall its sustained recoil is very easy to manage. So I think that's good news for console players. Even though I'm not a console player myself, from what I hear, that vertical recoil is a little bit trickier to control on console. So guns with less vertical recoil can potentially be easier to manage, easier to use. Now, how about attachments for this gun? The attachments that I use for it actually make the AEK slightly less accurate at range again, because I like to try and tame some of that side-to-side recoil by putting a foregrip on here. Now, the foregrip, as we all know, makes aiming down sight accuracy slightly less accurate, not by much, but just enough to the point where it's going to make those distance shots just slightly less effective, and you're really going to have to put a lot more bullets downrange to get a kill at longer distances. However, I like to also put a heavy barrel on the AEK, which actually makes up for the foregrip reduction in accuracy, for the most part anyway. And so what you're basically doing with a foregrip and heavy barrel is you're taking away some of that side-to-side recoil, and you're putting a little bit more into the vertical recoil. So you're just kind of exchanging one for the other. Since the AEK has such low vertical recoil, it's pretty easy to put more vertical recoil into it and still maintain a very good control of the gun, and the foregrip helps maintain that side-to-side accuracy or recoil much better. Now, of course, choosing a sight for a gun is really more of a personal decision. However, if you really want to take it down to a mathematical thing and talk about why the Cobra sight is probably one of the best sights to use, and if you just get used to it, you can overall be potentially a little bit more effective, you can check out my sight guide that I did, I think it was a few months ago, where I do a side-to-side comparison of the Red Dot sight and the Cobra sight, if you like those two sights, and it's talks about how much of the screen the little metal around the circle in the center of the sight takes up. And with the Cobra sight, it's just so little metal that you're really not obscuring any of your vision. And every now and then with the Red Dot sight, somebody will be hiding or right behind the metal of your sight in the middle of the screen, and you won't even be aware of it, and then you'll get shot by them. It's not very common, but the Cobra sight just it gives you that a little bit more visibility, and if you really are looking for any slight advantage that you can get in this game, then the Cobra is going to give that to you. So overall, the AEK is an absolute beast of a weapon. That 900 rounds per minute rate of fire is way more effective than 800 rounds per minute. I know it seems like only a slight increase and shouldn't make that big of a difference, but it really does, and I just ran out of ammo there, ending my insane kill streak. I just had a complete beast round, and the AEK really allowed me to do probably better than I would have with an M16 on this map, because it's close quarters. Again, you have to pick your maps accordingly. Close quarter maps are just wonderful for the AEK because of its rate of fire. So if you're looking to trying out the AEK, my biggest advice to you is learn when to reload the gun because of its long reload time. So conserve half of that magazine and check your surroundings. And check out that KDR, 149.28. Not too shabby, if I don't say so myself. I hope you guys enjoyed the AEK weapon review. Please remember to rate it up if you enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys next time. This is Level Cap, signing off.